tomorrow night under the baton Valery Gergiev at the Barbican. So Daniel Trifonov and Narek Hakhnazaryan are with me, and it's a great pleasure to welcome such beacons in this rather dark world of ours. Congratulations, first of all. What was it like? What was it like, Daniel, to go through a competition like Tchaikovsky?
Of course, it was an incredibly difficult challenge, this competition. Also, this time, level of participants, I think, was really high, as well as really demanding jury, containing one of the best musicians in the world. And before that, I was participating in Rubinstein competition.
You won the Rubinstein as well.
Also, it was also difficult to play one competition after another, but... in the beginning, of course, I was a little bit worried about my powers, emotional and physical, but it went successful.
It certainly did. Well, you know, Marta Argerich saying she was absolutely amazed by your playing and both the tenderness of it and the demonic side of it. To get a remark like that from an international icon like Marta Argerich is pretty exceptional, isn't it?
For me, of course, it was... I was very happy to read that such amazing musician listened to my recordings.
Yes, it's wonderful. Well, it's wonderful to not one but two. Narek, you're very welcome as well. You brought your cello, and yeah, you can certainly dazzle on that. My goodness, it's watching you roar up and down the G string a moment or two ago. Where did you start, and how was your competition?
Well, first of all, I would like to say about cello, since you mentioned it, that I got this cello 2 hours ago.
Ah.
Yes, and it is generously loaned to me by Florian Leonard, and it's a Stradivarius.
Ooh.
Of 1698. So it's one of the best cellos in the world. And I got this cello for the tomorrow performance.
Just for tomorrow?
Yes.
So it's just a brief affair. Will you have to give it back after tomorrow?
Oh, well, we'll see, yeah. And I'm very grateful, and it's amazing cello.
You signed it wonderful together. How long does it take to get an own instrument? Because people say you need to develop a relationship.
It depends on instrument, but with instrument of such a high level, it's not taking a long time.
Yes, you've got, of course, Daniel, just to play whatever piano comes to hand. You get very, do you get very cautious about practicing and getting to know an instrument or not?
Of course, it's very important to be flexible, and sometimes one of the best way of practicing is to practice on different instruments on the same day. Yes. For example, if I'm practicing in Cleveland Institute of Music, where I'm studying, usually I try to change piano every hour.
Wow.
and sometimes going out, like especially in the winter, so hands get cold, and when you return to the piano, and in these extreme conditions, you are practicing. It develops flexibility.
That's one way of putting it. Are you both aware of just how important this competition is to you? Have you been flooded with offers since you won? Have you had lots of people asking you to play?
Pretty much, yeah.
Are you being sensible about it or not?
Yeah, sensible in a good way. Well, I don't think we're both losing our, you know, head. I mean, we're in clear mind and not getting too excited, you know, and we are remembering that we're, first of all, we're musicians, and we need to develop and work on ourselves.
Yeah, so still more study for you, Daniel?
Of course, I'm only 20 years old, and I'm just a second-year student in the Cleveland Institute of Music. Yes, now it's important not to lose yourself in a labyrinth of concerts. But teacher help can be very helpful.
Yes. Well, gosh, you know, 20 years old, just starting out, and all this already. Well, it's wonderful that you're all going to play for us. You're going to wait for a moment, Narek, I think. You're under your Stradivarius. And I think, Daniel, you're going to play first for us. And it's two together. Originally, you were going to play them separately, but they work very well together, I think. They're both Liszt transcriptions of Schubert, and they've both got to do with sparkle and ripple and water and movement, haven't they? What are you going to play?
I'm going to play two transcriptions made by Liszt. It's two Schubert songs, Auf dem Wasser zu singen.
To be sung in the water, yeah.
Yeah, and Die Forelle.
The trout. So that's perfectly... Did you choose them because they had a had a shining and glittering connection.
Yes, obviously we have a relation.
Yeah, thank you very much indeed. Well, thank you. We'll let you approach our piano, Daniel. Thank you very much indeed. Daniel Trifonov playing live for us, Liszt transcriptions of Schubert.
Thank you.
Well, that was sublime. Musicality to his fingertips. There's a name to look out for. Daniil Trifonov, only 20 and playing like a dream. Beautiful. Actually, they worked together. I thought if I held my breath, you might just play some more. We just take the rest of the station off the air for the night. So when did you start, Daniil? Remember, when did you realise you had got something very special?
Well, I was born in a musical family, and my father is composer, and my mother is a teacher of theory of music. Of course, since childhood, I was surrounded by classical music. First attempts on piano, I started on about age of 5. And, of course, at that time, I was mostly just a composing. Mm. Full realize of how important it to me it was happened when I broke my left hand at age of 13. And for 3 weeks I could not play at all. My hand was in a
plaster.
Plaster. And it was torturous time for me.
So you really
because of absence of playing.
So it's as essential to you as breathing and eating then.
I cannot live without playing. If I don't have opportunity to play for more than one day, I feel myself in a bad condition.
So you went to specialist music school then?
I was studying in Gnesin's specialized music school in a class of Tatiana Zelikman. Among her students were Konstantin Lifshitz, Alexander Kobrin, Alexei Volodin,
that's all we're worried about at the moment. Narek, when did you realize that you and the cello were inseparable?
When I moved from Armenia with my mother to Moscow study in Moscow when I was 11 years old.
Mm. That was still a necessary path, was it? You really need to move to a big center like
that. Yes. And my family sacrificed a lot because my father and my two brothers stayed in Yerevan, and my mom left her job. She's a professor of Yerevan Conservatory. She's a wonderful pianist. And she left everything and moved with me to Moscow.
Wow.
As well as my parents.
They
also left everything in my hometown and we moved to Moscow.
Extraordinary. Yeah. It is extraordinary. I mean, it's almost impossible for us. They were so spoiled in this country. I can't imagine people moving their lives and moving their jobs because they see the talent and the promise in their children. It's an extraordinary thing to do.
Yeah.
They must be thrilled. They must be so proud of you.
We hope so.
Hope so too. They must have known. They're obviously very far-seeing parents. They knew there was something very special, didn't they? Did they have to push you at all to make you practice? Or?
Yes, they had to push me first 3 or 4 years because, you know, everybody like to play, but no kids like to practice, to play scales and do the boring stuff. But after 11 or 12 years old, I realized that it's a necessary part of our job. And if I want to enjoy stage and enjoy music making, I need to practice.
Did you give up football then?
Unfortunately, yes. Partly.
Well, I'm sure you would have been a very good footballer, sort of nimble fingers and sort of a good eye is needed there as well. But a bit dangerous for a cellist. You've got to watch your hands. You've got to watch your hands too, Daniil, haven't you? Be very careful of your hands on the piano.
Yes, of course. No any extreme sports except only walking and swimming. That's the only sport I do.
So where are you now then? You're going back, to Cleveland, is it? Where Cleveland School? Where are you studying?
I study in Cleveland Institute of Music for last 2 years with Sergei Babayan. He's a wonderful musician and...
Another Armenian.
Another. Yeah.
And I'm coming here on October to continue studying for a few days and then I will go again on concerts. Fortunately, in this institute there is a very flexible program, artist certificate, which... makes artists able to travel when he need.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, so very, very flexible. And what about you, Narek?
Well, I studied for 2 years with analogic program, artist diploma in Boston. Mm. And right now I'm doing a master's in Moscow Conservatory.
Oh.
Yeah, and it's pretty flexible too, so, yeah.
And then, well, the world is going to be your oyster. I can see there's not going to be a problem about that. We've had wonderful playing from Daniel. Really, very, very beautiful. Thank you very much indeed. Narek said, when we were discussing who should play first, Narek said, well, you can't have virtuosity after beauty. Well, that's a philosophy of life or not, but there's beauty in your playing, so we needn't worry about that at all. You are going to give us a little bit of dazzle on this wonderful borrowed Stradivarius cello, and it's variations on one string. Is it all on the G string? These variations by Rossini.
It's on a G originally on violin.
It's Paganini, but it's on a theme of Rossini.
It's a Paganini, and it's originally written for violin, and it's obviously much easier to play on violin because it's smaller and you can do it faster. But it's originally on G on violin, but on cello it's on A string on a top string.
On top string, so one string only.
Only one string.
Daring moment, and yes. Probably anybody with a vocal history, of course, will recognise it from Moses in Egypt, from Your Shining Throne, from Rossini, and it's Paganini. Thank you very much indeed. We're delighted that Richard Shaw is here to play with you. So it's Narek Akhmazadian and Richard Shaw, Variations on One String on a Theme by Rossini. Magnificent. Thank you very much indeed. Absolutely enthralling. Fantastic. And just to think that Narek only met a Stradivarius a couple of hours ago. Narek Haknazaryan, and thank you to Richard Shaw at the piano for that wonderful performance of Paganini based on a theme of Rossini. You looked as though it was the easiest thing in the world. Thank you. Thank you to Daniel Trifonov. Two names to look out for. Remember, you had them here and they were absolutely wonderful. I wish you every success and I hope you won't be too grand to come back and see us when you become appallingly famous. Thank you very much for being with us. Major gala tomorrow of the Tchaikovsky Winners Competition at the Barbican in London, the London Symphony Orchestra under Maestro Valeri Gergiev.